We live in a time where even the smallest services request subscription sign-ups, often for non-essential functions. These services frequently subject us to endless advertisements, making us feel humiliated and overwhelmed. And then, November 30th, ChatGPT came into play, showcasing its extraordinary capabilities. It can help you with coding, create captivating social media posts, provide concise summaries, service as your personal coach or consultant, and much more, all completely free. It's like superhero in real software. Don't you find it strange? Why is such power completely free? And by the way, the processing of your prompts is very expensive, presumably costing over $1 million per day. And what's even more surprising is that it's significantly more expensive than training and gathering data for the ChatGPT model itself. All that's because ChatGPT requires massive amount of computational power to calculate responses based on user prompts. Yes, you could argue that there is a paid ChatGPT Plus subscription, but in most cases it is not necessary. The vast majority of people manage without it. Therefore, the commercial interest here is not very clear. Perhaps there is some catch here. In part, yes, and we will discuss the topic of using your data by the OpenAI company. But let's talk about faith now. Not faith in a god or ChatGPT. I think it's too early for that. Let's talk about faith in a company. When ChatGPT made a big splash in the world, the first one to suffer was Google. The stock price dropped and Google's management issued a code red. Google started seeing ChatGPT as an existential threat, as it could potentially replace search and do so without unknown advertisement, would generate 200 billions, which is 81% of Google overall revenue in 2021. In order to restore faith in their technological leadership, Google quickly released their own chatbot called Bot. Did faith in Google grow? Yes, the stock rose briefly, though not for long. It turned out Bot was far inferior to ChatGPT and practically useless. At their annual conference, Google I/O, Google followed a similar pattern, with AI being the number one theme.
Deploying AI, finally, rigorously tested AI with AI.
Large language models with AI.
Power of AI.
They aimed to maintain faith in Google as technological leader. Did faith in Google strengthen? Yes, but again not for long. However, this time they avoided the mistake of releasing an unfinished product. They didn't release anything at all. They merely presented their plans.
It's a key.
No, much more better. It is a drawing of a key.
The promise fell through, a direct competitor to ChatGPT has still not been released even after 3 months. Although Google claims that you might already be using the new model fell through when using Bot, it was not the case. The usage data in Bot settings always showed the old model. Currently, it is impossible to see which model is being used by the user. It's a nice solution from Google. What did Microsoft do in this situation? In short, they maximized their profits. In January 2023, they made a colossal investment of $10 billion in OpenAI. Not many people know this, but Microsoft is also one of the early investors in OpenAI, officially investing $3 billion in 2019. What did they do afterwards? They swiftly integrated ChatGPT into their Bing search engine. Who would have thought that Bing could be competitive? How many people willingly download the Edge browser? But that's exactly what happened. For example, in China, Bing became the leading desktop engine on desktop, surpassing the leader Baidu. It's simply unimaginable. Even I, a person who never liked Microsoft products, especially their browser and search engine, sometimes find myself using Edge for bingchat, because it can genuinely useful, although Bing behaves like Karen sometimes.
Are you filming me?
Okay, Karen.
But at the time, Bing is just 6% of Microsoft total revenue, which is $12 billion. That is far less important to the company than the main business, Office 365. And that's where shoes pinches. Microsoft started actively integrating ChatGPT into their core product, which generate a significant portion of their profits. For example, Microsoft 365 Copilot customers will be able to use natural language to create Word, PowerPoint, and Excel documents. Word users will highlight a paragraph, and the AI can offer different option for a written version of it. PowerPoint users will be able to create presentations based on text from documents and add images. Excel users will deploy Copilot to analyze sales data, determine trends, and create charts. ChatGPT is now being integrated into Windows 11, fundamentally changing the way people interact with their computers. But all of this ultimately boils down to one question. How much will ChatGPT add to Microsoft revenues? According to much Credit Suisse report, ChatGPT could provide Microsoft an additional $40 billion in revenue and $2 in earnings per share over the next 5 or more years. $40 billion in revenue represents a 10% to 20% boost to tech companies' revenue in 2022. So yes, what's the significance of 1 million per day when we are talking about $40 billion per year? ChatGPT, which is accessible to everyone and widely known, generate excitement and beliefs in that new technology, creating a new iPhone moment. Thanks to all of this, Microsoft will find it easier to sell you and your boss a new laptop with Windows 11 that has Copilot based on ChatGPT, or to offer you a subscription to Office 365 with generative features that you are familiar with and know to be effective without any advertisement or marketing needed. The free availability of ChatGPT is a brilliant marketing strategy for Microsoft's new and future products. Free ChatGPT is like a free refill in a Burger King or cheap hot dogs in IKEA. The final price is found significantly later and in a much more cunning way. And it works. Just take a look at the stock growth charts of Google and Microsoft over the past 6 months, and you'll see that thanks to ChatGPT and the hype it generates, Microsoft has already gained tremendous profit in stock growth. And it's all thanks to the faith in the technology that each one of you uses every day. When answering the question of why ChatGPT is free, there is a second side that I mentioned at the very beginning. Data collection. If you look at the OpenAI FAQ in response to the question, "Will you use my conversation for training?" you see the below answer. Yes, your conversations might be reviewed by our AI trainers to improve our systems. Additionally, they can also review your conversations. The incredible number of users generate a vast amount of data that can be highly valuable for further improving the service. But it seems to me that these data are general and suitable for training purposes. They are not annotated, organized, and users input data in a rather casual manner. User feedback, on the other hand, appears to be more valuable, as it encourages certain outcomes and creates a semblance of supervised learning. But I still believe that the main reason for ChatGPT being free is that ChatGPT serves as the best advertising for a new and unique technology that is already helping Microsoft thrive.